Admiral Broadway Revue, brought to you by your Admiral dealer. The man to see for Admiral dual temp refrigerators, Admiral electric ranges, Admiral radios, phonographs, and magic mirror television. It's the Admiral Broadway Revue Encore. And comedy presents the All Request Show Encore. Thank you. presenting Olsen and Joy. Admiral Broadway Revue presents Sid Caesar in The Lost Check.
All right, come on, buddy. Hurry up. I ain't got all day.
Wonder what I did with the check.
Matty, you got a check?
I got a check. I just can't find it, that's all.
Uh-huh. I suppose you're going to claim you lost it?
I didn't say I lost it. I just can't find it for the moment.
Oh, sure.
All.
That's what they all say. My goodness, I can't imagine what happened. I just had it. Okay, I'll call a manager.
Look,
Charlie! Charlie don't like guys like you.
Look, I'm telling you, I'm not...
What's the trouble here?
Another deadbeat, Charlie, claims he lost his check.
Another one, huh? I don't understand this. What's the matter with you guys? Why don't you pay your checks?
Look, I'd gladly pay. I just can't find it, that's all.
Can't find it, huh? How many times have we heard that one, Arnold?
No, that's no story. I'm telling you, I just can't...
Aren't you ashamed of yourself going around chiseling meals?
No, I'm not chiseling
meals. Have I got any pride?
Now, listen, I gladly paid a check. It was only 35 cents.
35 cents? I bet he ate a buck and a quarter.
It was 35 cents.
What did you have to eat?
I had a chopped chicken liver sandwich and a cup of coffee.
On white or rye?
It was rye toast.
That proves he's lying. On toast, it's 40 cents.
All right. Maybe it was plain.
Why don't you just save us all a lot of trouble and produce the check?
Look, I gladly pay you the check. Look, I'll pay you the 35 cents. Look, I'll even pay you 40. I'll pay you a dollar. Just let me out of here, will you?
Oh, sure. It's simple, ain't it? You don't care what happens to our bookkeeping system. Well, we do. We gotta have a check for every guy that eats here.
What can I do? Print one?
Just a minute. What did you say you had to eat?
I had a chopped chicken liver sandwich and a cup of coffee.
Chopped chicken liver, huh? Arnold, who's chopping the chicken livers today?
I think it's Stanley.
Stanley? Stanley, we'll get to the bottom of this.
I got up from the table. I had the check in my hand.
Call me, boss!
This guy claims he had chopped liver.
Chopped chicken liver, eh? He looks more than me like a roast beef eater.
No, I didn't have any roast beef, I tell you. I had a chopped chicken liver sandwich. I'm sure I did. Look, when I was eating the sandwich, I remember I said it wasn't as good as my mother used to make.
Ah, now he's complaining.
Look, should I call Victor? Victor's carving the roast beef.
No,
call
Victor.
Victor!
Eats roast beef and insults my liver.
No, I'm telling you, all I had was a chopped chicken liver sandwich. You gotta believe me. I'll tell you, I had a chopped
chicken liver. What's up, boss?
Find out how much roast beef this swindler ate.
All right, open your coat.
All right, take it easy, will you? Please, I just had a chopped chicken.
Doesn't feel like roast beef to me. Feels more like turkey.
Turkey?
How much?
A drumstick?
That'll be a dollar.
A wing?
That's another dollar.
And an order of coleslaw on the side.
No. That'll be $2.50
altogether. $2.50, $2.50, no. Look, all I had was a chopped chicken of a sandwich. I wasn't even hungry. I just came in here to kill a half an hour.
All right, come on, buddy. You better pay up. Give. $2.50.
No, I'll find the check. I gotta.
You'd better not make any more trouble. You know there are names for guys like you.
You know what'll happen, don't you?
What?
Look, why waste time? Call a cop.
Yeah, that's what we'll do. We'll call a cop. We'll come in a wagon. Put him away where he belongs.
No, you can't do that. You can't call a cop.
Wouldn't hurt him to spend a night in a cell.
Jail's too good for guys like him.
He's probably got a record a mile long. I'll go get the police.
No, don't get the cops. I gotta find this check. I think I must have been someplace in here. I gotta find this check. My wife, my kids. I'll be displaced. Everybody. I gotta find this. Nobody knows where this is. I gotta find this check. If I have to find it, I know what I'll do. I gotta find the check now. It must be here someplace. I gotta find it. It's gotta be here. I know it's got the check. It's gotta be here someplace. I know it's gotta be. Wait a minute. I think. Yeah, sure. I remember now. There. There's the check. There's the check. I don't care now no more. You see? There's the check. You thought I was lying to you, didn't you? There's the check. There's the check.
How much is it?
35 cents.
Ah! You guys wouldn't even trust your own mother, huh? Yeah. Oh, boy, I can be pretty tough with all my... Hey, pull the cops off! Hey, kid. Wonder how many times you guys pull that on me, somebody. Well, you think I'd hear a hick or something? Get down with me, boy. When you fall around, you gotta fall out. Remember that, boy. I can make a pretty tough with a whole bunch of...
All right, come on. Pay the check. We ain't
gonna
pay.
Hey, call the wagon.
Come on. Pay the check.
Cops.
Well, what's the matter now?
I think I forgot my wallet.
Charlie!
The Admiral Broadway Revue recognizes the popular wave of ballet in the theater today. One of the major classic ballets is Debussy's Afternoon of a Faun. Well, at this time, Imogene Coca and William Archibald will present their own version of The Afternoon of a Faun. Newsreel reporter Frank Waldecker with an on-the-scene interview at LaGuardia Airport, where the international representatives of the motion picture industry are just arriving to attend the annual cinema conference being held here in America. First, we'd like to interview the representative of the vast French motion picture industry, Monsieur François Duval. Monsieur Duval, we understand that you are very enthusiastic about the motion picture that you're entering in the international contest.
Oui, oui, oui.
Would you tell us something about that picture?
Oh, mon sentiment. Gilberto Savary de Bancheret, des Antipas. Les années 60, the long gibi de Marais, des Angevilles. I will explain to you in English. It is beautiful. It is so simple, you know. It is very simple. It is not with the technique and the gorgeous costumes. It is very simple. It is just about a love story. L'amour, la sassoir du bille papa de la magnifique. But there's one scene with Jean Gabin, Simon. Oh, she is beautiful. He is walking down the boulevard. Oh, I will show you. Ah, this is wonderful. He's walking down the boulevard. Oh, bonsoir, madame. Rêve le penseur, très disant, j'avais le plancheret des sas, de veulent même leur. Hey, bien sûr, hey, come back, madame. Stock up. Dans un rêve, par l'objectif, en rêve. Personne. Simon. C'est les bocherets qui sont après tout là, papa. Donne un chépard, dis-le, balade. Vous allez laisser votre voyage. Tu n'avais pas prêté ta sirène. Je la l'arrête, la charité, c'est votre camarade. Je l'arrête. J'ai perdu la forêt. De la lips. J'ai le bocheret derrière de la fingers. In between the fingers. Under the fingernails. Je vais pas se faire de son rêve, il faut que je l'arrête de ce brave. Où je m'éparpe, où j'ai perdu mal. Où j'ai perdu de l'amour. C'est bien pas, n'est-ce pas, hein, Roger Savary?
Monsieur, what is the name of this picture?
School Days.
Now, just stepping off the plane, the representative of the Russian motion picture industry, Mr. Alexander Dmitrikov. Mr. Dmitrikov, would you tell us something about the motion picture that you're entering in the International Film Contest?
Да-да. За лукокнем ещё положил как новый уже умеем иметь, понял. За окно еду франжу родные. Пока не дорожил окно мимо. За окно стоит, за окно. За ней тебе ещё клай. Play, simple. Earth. За рухлой чли не вывел. Рахлу не вывел. За окно ебал. За не пьящий за окно. Story of man. Ну, one man. Рухлай. О, one beautiful scene. Зине крайца, гурумы вышла, мельзох, рух, вы мне мневайся, захрё. За ну пьёте вахле, фарест, блэк, за ну крайца, не нюмой. Зихлоите с норами, погоняйте, ай, сохраню, лёжка блёкна, кол, ах, не мневыч, пожалохна, я, о, бой, о, бой, о, бой. Храните прохлой, из не лучше прожило, зине кик, за валяма. Мель, захрю, и ту фарест. Эх, рахну, за рукой, ночью пронул. Знечу дало, захлоги. Захлоги, певец, охлоел. Дал, let go, прохлоивача. Захлоил, let go, let go, прохлоивача. Захлоил, я кривый. Знаете, что ж, я не ухлоил. Понимай, иду фаст. Прохлоя, пенеется заложа. Как ты, Биг Бе. Захлоил, пе, захломичи, бахлоил. За хулимич пахлай, за него эти пожелохлая. Last time, грахлуич, мне ведь прохлой, да начал хранимать пахлая. Захра, понимай, брахнеть, понимай, я.
Mr. Dimitri Coughlin, what is the name of this film?
The Sissy.
Thank you, Sid Caesar.
This boss?
Right down here, Sam.
Hey, what's that?
That's a going away present one of our friends sent us. Since we're closing our television showroom for the summer, he thought it would make a nice beau voyage present. Will you set it up in the other room, please?
Yeah, sure. I feel like a Kentucky Derby winner.
From this end, you look like one, too. Well, friends, as you heard me telling Sam, this is the last night we'll be meeting you in the showroom for a while, so I'm going to depart from my usual routine. I'm not going to put the usual pressure on. Instead, I'm going to give you a brief panoramic look at the many things Admiral has to make your home life more enjoyable. So let's start on this parade of pleasure right over here. First, let's look at some of Admiral's ultra-modern kitchen appliances, such as the super deluxe two-oven Admiral Selectric range, with two cooking ovens and featuring a rotissimat, an Admiral exclusive that brings barbecuing right into the home. And here we have the Admiral Dual Temp Refrigerator, a two-in-one combination home freezer and refrigerator that eliminates having to cover any food you put in it, eliminates all food odors, and most of all, eliminates defrosting. Yes, friends, with the Admiral Dual Temp, there's no defrosting. Now, right over here, we have Admiral's line of portable radios, beginning with this small, light $19.95 battery model, and including these three stylish portables that sell for $29.95, $49.95, and in genuine Cordovan leather, $69.95.
Hey, boss, what do you want me to put this?
Right down there, Sam. Now, folks, I'd like to tell you
about... Who are you talking to?
Why, all our friends out there.
You mean all the people who are sitting to see the rest of the show? The top of the evening to you is Caesar. The champions. Waiting for you to come on?
Not exactly, Sam. But here's something really worth waiting to see. These Admiral table model radios, styled to fit any room in your house and priced to fit everybody's pocketbook. They start as low as $14.95 and come in maroon, ebony, mahogany, and ivory. And here we have Admiral's table model radio phonograph, the only combination on the market that features the three-speed triple play changer. And it sells for $69.95. And now, Admiral Magic Mirror Television. Admiral, you know, makes all models and all sizes, from 7-inch up to 16-inch picture tubes. Now here, for instance, is Admiral's table model television set. It requires no installation, no landlord's permission, and it sells for only $169.95 in ebony. And you can also get it in mahogany. And here, friends, is America's number one television value, the Admiral 3-Foot Theater. The complete home entertainment combination that has everything. Dynamagic AM and FM radio, Admiral's exclusive triple play automatic phonograph and Admiral Magic Mirror television. All for as little as $399.95 in walnut. And it comes in mahogany or blonde, as you see it here. And now, we save the biggest and the best to the last. Here it is, friends, the handsomest, finest-looking television combination you could want in your home. In addition to the exclusive radio phonograph features you saw in the 3-foot theater, this Admiral console features a big 16-inch television screen that brings you the finest, clearest picture you've ever seen. You can get it in mahogany for $695, also available in block.
Hey, boss.
Yes?
Are you still talking to all those patient people?
Yes, but I've just about finished, Sam. Except to tell our friends that all these wonderful Admiral products will be available at their local Admiral dealers all summer. So long, everybody. See you in September. Come on, Sam.
Encore, Miss Imogene Coca in Fur Fashions on Parade.
A pretty girl is just like a pretty number. It's good, you know, for practically every occasion. It's so basic and so black. Aren't the skins simply divine? They're really so beautifully matched. So durable. Now, on those... so few occasions when you couldn't possibly wear this number, may I suggest this next hilt. Well, frankly, I feel it more or less talks for itself. And very often does. Wish you could feel it. Such depth and such beauty. Can't you just sort of see yourself walking down? Well, let's face it, nothing is very stable these days. Now, in my opinion, mind you, this is only my own opinion, and I certainly don't want to thrust it on you, but in my... Oh, yes, of course. I bagged that this morning. Central Park is simply overrun. They'll really have to do something. Notice the bracelet cuff. Isn't that yummy? Now you'll find that this number is terribly good for skating in the park, sleighing, sheeing, hockey, any casual sort of winter sport. There we are. Let winter come. This is the new look. Why fight it? Has a pocket for small change. You worship the kick feet. Aren't the lines simply magnificent? Speaking of lines, notice the lining. We feature the lining of this number. It's reversible. And water repellent. Did you ever see such soft, lovely bellies in your whole life? Now, the thing we really feature about this number, not only is it good for winter sports, you can do practically anything in this coat. Within reason, naturally. You know what I'm going to do? Oops. I'm just going to be utterly honest and admit that this is my favorite. You know what appeals to me about this number? The sheer, stark simplicity. We're calling this the snake pit. So why have her look like a witch? Wrap her in beautiful silver blue muskrat, and you'll find that a pretty girl is just like a pretty girl.
Admiral Broadway Revue welcomes back Marge and Gower Champion, dancing for you an episode called Reencounter.
Maybe you're wondering what happened. Well, perhaps I can tell you. Let's suppose that one night, you're at a party. There are people. It's all very formal and conventional. And then you see this girl, someone you haven't seen for a long time. As a matter of fact, an old romance. So you meet, you talk, maybe you dance a little. And the strange and wonderful thing about it is that you're never quite sure if she looked at you in just the way you imagined. You're never quite sure if she meant what you thought she meant. You're never quite sure, in fact, if the whole thing happened at all, or if it were just something that might have happened.
Oh,
the many heartwarming dramas which are played every day behind the walls of the buildings in a large city, one of the most fascinating is the one which takes place in the operating room of a hospital. We bring you now Miss Imogene Coca in a soul-stirring drama entitled Surgery Strikes Back.
Oh, boy, what a head I've got. I can hardly keep my eyes open.
You'd better hurry. Dr. Willoughby doesn't like to be kept waiting.
Oh, is this Dr. Willoughby's case?
Yes, gallbladder. Oh, boy, what a head I've got. I can hardly keep my eyes open.
Oh. Well, is the patient ready? The chief will be here in a minute.
Yes, are you assisting Dr. Willoughby?
Yes, blast it. Oh, what a head I've got. I can hardly keep my eyes open.
Hey, what is this? Everybody's got a hangover.
No, don't worry. Dr. Willoughby does all the operating. Here comes the doctor now.
Oh, boy, what a head I've got. I can hardly keep my eyes open. Nurse, where's my patient? Oh, there you are, my man. You're looking well. How do you feel? That's good. Why isn't the patient on the operating table?
Doctor, Dr. Willoughby, this is the patient.
Oh, so it is, so it is. What's the trouble, my man?
But you told me you knew.
Oh, so I did, so I did. Something about an operation, wasn't it? Well, we'll get right to work. Have you any last requests to make? Any messages for your relatives?
Hey, what is this?
Nurse, you better start preparing the anesthetic. Doctor, Scrubbable Boy.
Yes, sir.
By the way, I had quite an interesting talk this morning with Dr. Armour. Conceited puppy. Kept boasting he could perform an appendectomy blindfolded. He said I couldn't do it.
I'm sure you could.
Of course I could. With one hand, too. By gad, it's almost worth it.
I've changed my mind. I'm better. I want to go home.
Easy.
No, I just remembered I got
an
appointment.
You're a lucky chap, my man. We're going to try a new type of anesthetic on you. Spinal injection. Wonderful stuff. Never been tried before. You'll be awake right through the operation.
Awake? Will there be any pain?
None to speak of.
Oh, I don't want it. Give me ether.
Come. A little pain never hurt anybody.
I want ether. I don't want any pain.
I assure you there will be no pain. A little agony, yes, but no pain.
Yes, Doctor. Dr. Willoughby, would you like to use the new electric needle?
Let me see, nurse. Ah, yes, that's it. Wonderful gadget. Well, I guess we're just about ready. Have faith. There, that didn't hurt, did it? In a minute, you won't feel a thing below your chest. Scalpel, nurse. Just a minute. There aren't enough sterile towels here.
I prepared the usual amount, Doctor.
Well, prepare some more. I expect quite a mess.
Yes.
Hello, my little man.
Mess!
I
mean, nurse, I want to test your degree of anesthetization.
Ah! Oh, ready. Now, observe closely, Doctor. First, we make a lateral incision parallel to the dorsal aorta, like this. In doing this, you must be very careful not to cut the carotid artery, which is right here, which is right there, which is, Oh, it's around there someplace. Next, we make longitudinal incision, 14 inches long, at right angles to the lateral incision, which is 42 inches long. There we are. Ghastly, isn't it? Always remember, Doctor, this is a very delicate type of incision and should be used only in cases of kidney trouble.
Oh, but Doctor, this is a gallbladder case.
Oh, so it is, so it is. Just relax, my man. You still have a chance.
Yeah, but Doctor, don't you...
Let's see, where were we? Ah, yes, we had just made an incision in the left lung. Now we do the right.
Doctor!
This is a gallbladder case.
Oh, so it is, so it is. Observe closely, Doctor. First, we cut through the anterior abdominal muscles, and what do we find? The posterior abdominal muscles. We cut through those, severing the ligamental cords, and we, Hello. What's this I'm cutting here? I don't seem to recognize it. Oh, it's just the spinal cord. Now, by stripping the periosteum and raising the plaque, we find what, Doctor?
The gallbladder?
Correct. And here it is. Here it... That's strange.
It's not there.
Exactly. Just what are you trying to pull here, my man?
What do you mean, Doctor?
Come out with it. Don't lie. Where's your gallbladder?
Yeah, but I...
Oh, lie down. I'll look again. And here we are, Doctor. Here is the root of all the trouble. Well, just a matter of mopping up now.
Dr. Willoughby, may I say that in all my experience in med college and as an intern, I have never witnessed a more exciting, a more stimulating, a more complete operation than you have just performed.
Bravo, bravo. Thank you very much. And now, for my encore, I shall blindfold
you. No, no, you don't.
Ladies and gentlemen, Admiral presents Sid Caesar.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now in the midst of what they call a movie cycle. That I mean, almost all the movies coming out of Hollywood are about the same subject, namely boxing. Such as Body and Soul, The Champion, The Setup. I should like to give you my version of one of these boxing pictures. This one is called The Schmo. These pictures always start out with the hero lying on his back on the canvas in the ring, and the referee is counting over him.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now, between the counts of 5 and 6, the whole life of the fighter passes before his mind.
4, 5, 6. Hey, Ma! Ma, it's coming down bread, butter, sandwich. Thanks, Ma. Hey, Janie. Janie, you're my girl. Oh, come on, Janie. Let's go take a walk. Yeah. We'll go down by our favorite spot. We'll go down by the dumps. Yeah. Come on. That's it, Janie. You're my girl, boy. Nobody else's. Yes, sir. I'm going to do big things. Yeah. You and me together, we'll do big things. I'm not going to be a hey you all my life. I'm going to be a mister. Yes, sir. I'm going to do big things together, both of us. But right now, I got to go to the pool room. I'll meet you after. Hi, Charlie. Hi, Mike. Hey, Pete. How are you doing? The horse come in yet? No, huh? All right. Bet your quarter I make this shot. Bet. 2 bets, you're on. I got it. There. Pay up the 2 bits.
I got paid. It was an illegal shot.
What do you mean? What do you mean it was an illegal shot? I was a...
You had your foot off the ground. It wasn't an illegal shot. It was illegal.
It was not illegal. I'm not going to throw it. You're going to pay me the 2 bits?
No, I ain't going to pay you. It was illegal. Okay, then take this.
I'll pay the 2 bits, huh? What do you want?
Pretty handy with your mitts, aren't you, sonny? How'd you like to go into the ring? Become a boxer.
What? Get my brains knocked out? No. I'll go be a chemistry teacher. Yes, sir.
Right. Well, anytime you change your mind, sonny, let me know. Your name is Mike Mallon. Here's my card. Get me at the Gotham gym anytime you want.
Okay, when I want you, I'll need you. I'll find you. So long. I'm not gonna meet my girl. Janie! Janie, what are you doing with a guy like that? You had a date with me. What? Oh, he's a big shot. Makes $15 a week, huh? All right, go ahead, go with him. That's all you wanted was money anyway.
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah, I could make money too. Sure, and I will. I'll make it with my fists. Sure, I'll be a fighter. That's what I'll do. I'll become a fighter. What was the name of that guy? Mike Mallon, sure, the Gotham gym. I'll be a fighter. Am I ready yet, Mike? Not yet, huh? Am I ready yet, Mike? Not yet, huh? Keep your left up, all right? Keep your left up, that's what I said. Keep your left up, keep your left. Show me my left hand, I'll keep it up. Watch it, my left hand. That's all.
All right, hey, Bob.
A lot of road work. Mike, am I ready yet? I'm not ready. All right. Mike, am I ready yet? I am. Okay, I'll fight. Where is he? All aboard! Woo! Woo! Pittsburgh! Yeah, yeah, hit him out there! I gotta hit him down! Hit him left, left, left! And a winner, yeah! Kansas City, yeah, yeah! Hit him in the LaBonzi, yeah! LaBonzi! Hit him, yeah! And a winner, yeah! Woo! Mexico City! Hey, caliente, signore, que vengo con la signore de mea, el tibala, come on, you bull, blah! I don't win a game! Woo! New York City!
Hey, you!
Me?
Yeah, come over here.
Okay. What do you want?
I like a nice fighter like you. You got lots of guts. Big and strong. You're mine!
What do you mean I'm yours? Why? Why should I be yours? Why? Sure, why? Why should I be yours? What do you mean I'm yours? Why?
Because. I won your contract last night from your manager in a game of pinochle. And that's why.
What do you mean? You think I'm a piece of cheese you can win over a counter? Yeah, sure, why? What do you mean you can win me? What am I, something? Yeah, why?
You're mine! I'll tell you what we're gonna do with you. I'm gonna take you up to my place in the country. I'm gonna get you nice in a train, good. They have the best trains for you, lots of roadway, good food. And then I'm gonna send you on a road. And you're gonna fight the finals, no more semifinals. And then when you're in top condition, you're gonna come to the garden, fight the champ. And in the sixth round, you'll lose.
What do you mean I lose? Why should I lose? What do you mean I lose? Why?
For $65,000. That's why, sonny. Think it over. I'll be back a little later.
$65,000. I gotta take a dive, throw the fight. I gotta go see me mother. Ma, look who's home. Stevie's home.
My boy's come home.
My boy's home. Yeah, Ma, what are you crying for? Ma, why are you crying? I got plenty of money. Sure, I'm rich. Sure, look at these clothes, Ma. Look at this suit. $200. I got it in Pittsburgh. Look at the shirts, Ma. $30 a piece. I got them in Kansas City. Look at this, Ma. I got this in Montreal. See that? Ma, what are you worrying about? We got plenty of money. I'm going to take you out of this damp, dark, dirty dump. Sure, I'm going to take you to a place where there's sun and sunshine and fresh air. I'll move you across the street. Sure. What are you crying about, Ma? Here, Ma. Here's plenty of money. Go ahead. Stop crying, Ma. Hey, kids, there's Stevie. Hey, Stevie, you're going to win the fight tonight. Hey, Stevie. All right, kids. Hey, Stevie, you're going to win tonight because we bet 19 cents on you, huh? Hey, we bet 19 cents. You got to win tonight for us. Win the championship, ain't you? All right, kids. All right.
Sure, I'll win. Look at them kids. Look up to me like a hero. What a hill I am. They bet their last 19 cents on me. And I'm going to throw the fight for $65,000. I'll give them their 19 cents back.
All right, Steve, come in here. Step on the scale.
Hi, Doc. All right, 195 3/4. Okay, right.
Hi, Doc.
All right, Steve, lots of luck on the fight tonight. Just want to test your heart. All right.
He's okay. All right.
$65,000 if I lose, but if I win, I'll make $100,000. What a schmo! Yay! And new heavyweight champion of the world! Yay!
Encore! The Admiral Broadway Revue presents The Freight Yard Ballet. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last of the Admiral Broadway Reviews for this season. Now, on behalf of the entire acting company, I should like to thank everyone connected with the show. Stagehands, cameramen, technicians, musicians, everyone, as our thanks. And of course, our deepest gratitude to you, the television audience. Because, well, you've received this at such a... You received this with such a wonderful way. We want to thank you. And so, until next September, we meet again. Bye and good luck.
Well, folks, that does it. Until next September, meanwhile, your Admiral dealer, the man to see for Admiral dual-temp refrigerators, electric ranges, radios, record players, and magic mirror television, invite you to enjoy the new television version of Stop the Music. Check your local newspaper for time and station.